Okay, so this is changing the print roller on a Samsung SX4521F.
And the procedure is exactly the same on a Samsung ML2010.
First step, and remove manual feed mechanism. You just pick up and out she comes. I never use this, so I just set it aside here underneath and hope it lives a happy life there. And take the corner cartridge out, and then I set it on a piece of paper because you don't want to scratch up. You don't want to scratch up this green roller here. That's where the image is transferred, and if you scratch that up, then you're going to have a damaged image. So now we can get at the print roller.
You can see how cracked up the old roller is.
And if you look in the text underneath this video, you'll see a link for where you can buy pickup rollers like this. And if you notice, there's a little tab sticking out on the top on this side and one on this side. So I have made up a little tool here out of coat hanger wire. With this, I can reach in and pull that little tab out.
I can get a little bit of light on this thing. There we go. If I reach in with this, hopefully you can see. You can see I'm pulling this little tab out a bit.
Mm-hmm.
And there's one tab on each side to pull out like that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so there I pulled out the tab, and then I pulled up on this on the right side to sort of get the roller to bump up a little bit. Now the tab has stayed out.
Okay, there we go. Now you can see that by pulling out that little tab and then pulling up this way, right here, on this roller, I got the roller to sort of bump out and stay out.
Okay, I'm holding that tab down with my finger. Hopefully it'll come on, so I'm going to put the hook in here. There we go. Okay.
I've got it.
And off it came, finally. It may destroy your relationship with someone doing this. Okay, so now, here's the old one, which, if we look at it, it's in there. You can see it's got breaks in it there. So that's not a great one. You can just buy new rubber and put it back on your existing roller thing here, but it was the same price I found just to buy a whole new assembly. So the trick with this is, hey, there's two little, get the lighting right here, there's two little tabs here on each side, and they're going to hook into right here, right there is a little slot. Anyway, so the idea, those little tabs are going to hook into the two slots on the bottom, and then I'll rotate the new roller up into place. Okay, so on this roller, there's two different kinds of tabs. The one on the right here is a longer one, and the one on the left is a little bit rounder. Try the little round ones on the bottom. They might be easier to... Yeah, okay.
Okay, there we go. Showing that we put the bottom tab in, a little round bottom tab in the slot.
And now I'm going to just roll it over up towards the top. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Okay, it's in.
Okay, so now it's time to put it back together again. Here's this inside piece that really I never use because that's for hand feeding sheets, but I'll put it in anyway just to be a good fella. Here is the toner cartridge. That goes in, it clips into place. Okay. Swing up the door, clip that shut, down comes the paper thing. Let's see how she works. Turn on the power. Let's send something to print.
Here's why I was making that rat-a-tat-tat-tat sound, because
You can see that gap there? That means the roller isn't on all the way.
There we go.
I had to grab behind here on both sides and then press it in. That's just clicked in. Now hopefully you can see there's no longer a big gap in between this roller and whatever the heck the roller is clipping onto, whatever that's called.
If you look in the text underneath the video, you'll see where you can buy a pickup roller for your printer. You can see it if the paper's going in, huh? Comes.
You want to try and do this?